Hey guys, this is Shubham and welcome to another video lecture of this call log tracker app tutorial series. In the previous video, we have learned to send the data to the Firebase database from our app where we are fetching the data, call log data from the Android device. If you haven't watched that video, then please check out the description below and you can click on the link which is currently showing at the top right corner of your screen. So just watch that video first, otherwise you will not able to understand in the codes which I explain in this video. So just watch out that before starting this video. So and in this video I will show you how you can implement the codes to hide the app from the Android device's launcher, so it will not be visible to anyone until you go to the settings and go to the apps, and there you can see the apps, but then also you will not able to open the app. And I will also show you how you can open the app by using a specific number. So by dialing a specific number you can open the app. That we will learn in this video, so let's get started without wasting any time. So guys, I am in my project. Now we will implement our code to hide the app from the device. So we will open the main activity as it is open. Now we will add a function, override method by clicking on Control and O, and we will write on pause. Okay, we will add this method here. Okay, so this method will be called whenever this activity goes in the background. Means you minimize the app or you click on the recent activities button, so it will go to the background. So we are hiding the app whenever it goes to the background. So I've already written the codes, so I will just copy the codes and will paste it. So what we are doing here is we are just creating a package manager and we are initializing it. Okay, and the second thing, we are creating a component of main activity. So as we have only one activity, main activity, so we are making the component of the main activity, and this component we will open and close. We will disable or enable the view of this component. So by how we can do that, in the next line we are calling the package manager dot set component enabled setting. Okay, so by this method dot set component enabled enabled setting method, we will make it visible and invisible. So inside this we are passing the component which we have created, the main activity. First parameter will be the component. The second parameter is the flag, package manager dot component enabled state disabled. So we are just disabling the state of this component. Okay, so you will not be able to access this component when you minimize this app. Okay, and the last parameter is package manager dot don't kill app. So and the last parameter, which is package manager dot don't kill app, so this is the flag. So as you can see by its name, the don't kill app, so it will force the OS don't to kill this app or activity. So it will remain as it is in the background until we will open this activity, we will enable this activity state, so this component state. Now we have written the codes to hide the activity. Now how we can open this activity? So to open this activity we need to add a broadcast receiver. So what we have to do is we have to create a class which extends the broadcast receiver class. So we will name it as my receiver. Okay, and it is a class, so I've created this class and this will extend to broadcast receiver. So whenever we dial a number, so it will and call it, so it will receive this by using this class, this broadcast receiver, and will do the do the function which we will implement here. So for that we have to add this in the manifest file also. So we will I've already written the code. So this receiver you have to add in the manifest file. So click on open the manifest file, and inside the application tag you will have to add this receiver. So inside the receiver, the name will be the class name my receiver, okay, dot my receiver. And inside intent filter we'll have the action and name is new outgoing call. Okay, so we have added our receiver in the manifest file. So whenever you dial a number and call it, so it will be received by this class, my receiver class of the app. So we will implement the methods. So there is a method on receive which we need to add. Okay, the added. Now I will write our code which I have added. So I will explain you later what needs to be done. Okay, I will keep this as comment out because I've already tested our code. I will copy this line which is the constant and I will paste it here. So basically this is the specific number which we have stored in this constant show app code. So you can write anything here, 9 or 9999 as 1234, or you can remove the hash, you can just write 1234, anything you want. So I'm just writing here *1234 hash. Okay, I will use this number to open my app. And inside the receiver, okay, inside the receiver, whenever you dial a number from the dialer, it will receive it will be received by this receiver. Okay, and we are initializing a dial number with null. Okay, and again we are checking if this dial number is null, then we are assigning the phone number which we have dialed into this dial number. Okay, so suppose if I am dialing some number, some random number, so it will, when we press the call button, then it will received that that action will be received by this my receiver class, and the number which we have dialed is accessed by this intent.extra phone number. So it will be fetched by this, and we are storing that number into this dial number. Okay, and after that, the number which we have dialed, we are comparing with our show app code. Okay, so whenever the dial number will match with the show app code, then our app should open. So that's the logic. So inside this, we have just written the same code which we have written in the onPause method in the main activity. So we are just creating a package manager and initializing it by context.get package manager, and we are creating a component of main activity that we will that we have disabled in the main activity, but from here we will have to enable it. So in the next line, we have used the same method set component enabled setting, and inside this we are passing the component main activity. And the second method, we have passed the component enabled state disabled in the main activity, right? In the main activity we are disabling it, but here in the my receiver Java class we have to enable it to open the app. Okay, so and after that we will have to call this don't kill app flag. That's all. And after that we have enabled our main activity class, then we have to just create an intent to open the main activity. Okay, so we are just writing the intent. So we are creating the instance of intent, and we are passing the context which is the current context, and the second parameter is the activity which we want to open. And then we are just adding the flag activity new task. After that we are just starting that activity. So that's all in this code. Now we will just check in the emulator whether it is working or not. We are running it. Okay, let's wait to the app to be installed in our emulator. Okay, so our app is installing. Yeah, it is installed. So As you can see, it is installed. Now what I will do is I will just minimize this app. Okay, I have minimized this app. Now if I go to the recent activities, so you can see it is gone. Okay, it is gone after a few seconds, after a few milliseconds. So that's not an issue. So if you check in the menu, means the launcher, if you check in the launcher, you will not find that app call log. Okay, so how you can open that? You have to open that by dialing a specific number, right? So we have to go to phone, and here we have to type our show app code. Okay, so we have set our code like *1234 and hash. If you call this number, the app will open. See, that's the magic. And again, if you click on recent or minimize, so it will be gone. And again, if you click on the phone, and again, if you dial the same number, again, the app will open. So that's all for this video, guys. If you like this video, then please press the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get the latest updates of my new videos. And if you face any issue with the codes or you have any doubt, please feel free to add your comments in the comment section below. You can connect with me through the social media. You can ping me on Instagram, LinkedIn, or in the Facebook chat. I will try to answer you all. So please feel free to ask any question which comes into your mind. And don't worry about the codes. I have given the link of my GitHub repository in the description below. So for the codes, you can check out the repository. And if in case if you have any issue understanding anything in the code, so you can ask me anytime. So see you in the another video, guys. In the next video, we will be discussing about the periodic work request. So we will set an interval of 15 minutes so that it will we will send the data without the knowledge of user. So we will set that in the next video. So keep watching, guys, and take care and stay safe.